Hi everyone, in this video we'll discuss how to test the construct validity using CFA outputs from AMOS. We have tested the construct reliability in the previous video. The next step is to test the construct validity. In DAV726, I have a video explaining the concept of construct validity and two types of validity, convergent validity and discriminant validity. In this video, we'll perform these validity tests using CFA outputs. There are several ways of testing construct validity. Byrne 2010 introduced the method so-called multi-thread multi-method. This is a popular method of testing construct validity, especially discriminant validity. However, this method requires multiple thread factors and method factors, which might not be available in all studies. Head-on 2010 Chapter 13 introduced a more effective method using Average Variance Extract, or AVE. This method is easier to perform and provide more accurate evaluation of construct validity. In this video, we'll use this method. First, let's examine the convergent validity. Convergent validity refers to the extent to which measures of the same construct are correlated. In other words, it provides empirical evidence that items that are indicators of a specific construct should converge or share a high proportion of variance in common. Typically, we can use standardized factor loadings to evaluate the convergent validity. Factor loadings of 0.7 or higher indicate good convergent validity, and factor loadings of 0.5 or higher indicate acceptable convergent validity. The second method is to use AVE to evaluate the convergent validity. This is a formula for AVE. We have sum of square factor loadings divided by the number of items. We will use Excel to calculate AVE using CFA outputs. This is the CFA model that we have tested and confirmed. Let's look at the outputs. Select estimates. We will find standardized factor loadings. Right click and select copy. Then paste these values to Excel. These are factor loadings for three factors, F1, F2, and F3. By examining factor loadings, we can see that all factor loadings of F1 are greater than 0.5, indicating good conversion validity. However, for F2 and F3, we do notice some items with factor loadings less than 0.5. Let's calculate AVE for each factor. Per the formula, we need to get the sum of square factor loadings. First, we calculate square factor loadings. We add another column and call it square loadings. Equal sign, click on the loading value, which is cell D4, cap sign 2, this means square, and hit enter. Then we just need to copy down the function by moving the pointer to the lower right corner and drag it down. Now we have all square values of factor loadings. In next column, we calculate AVE for each construct. We will use average function. Equal sign, average, parenthesis, highlight all square factor loadings for F1, which is E4 to E12, close parenthesis, and hit enter. We have AVE value for F1 is 0.495. We do the same for F2. Equal sign, average, parenthesis, highlight all square loadings for F2, which is E13 to E17, close parenthesis, and hit enter. We have AVE value for F2 is 0.38. Similarly, we calculate AVE for F3. Equal sign, average, parenthesis, highlight all square loadings for F3, which is E18 to E24, close parenthesis, and hit enter. We have AVE value for F3 is 0.359. The rule of thumb is that AV values of 0.5 or higher indicate good convergent validity. We see that AV for F1 is 0.495, which is close to 0.5, so it is considered acceptable. However, AV values for both F2 and F3 are less than 0.5. This evaluation is consistent with what we have noticed from examining factor loadings. I would recommend reporting both factor loadings and AV values when we evaluate convergent validity. In this case, we can conclude that there is not sufficient evidence to confirm convergent validity for F2 and F3. Some changes might have to be made, such as removing the item with the lowest factor loading and run the CFA model again. The rule of thumb is to remove one item at a time. Nonetheless, note that CFA is a theory-driven method, so we need to review the theory and literature and examining each item carefully before deleting any item. And we have to make sure to have enough items for each factor, otherwise the model will be affected. The next step is to test discriminant validity. Discriminant validity refers to the extent to which constructs are distinct. That means discriminant validity provides empirical evidence that a construct is unique and captures some phenomena that other constructs do not. In this video, we will use the most popular method proposed by Fortnell and Lacker in 1981. Essentially, this method compares the AVE for each construct with the square variance between that construct and other constructs. There are two ways to make this comparison. The first way is to compare the square root of AVE for each construct with all correlation estimates between that construct and other constructs. If the square root of AVE is greater than all of those correlation estimates, then we have evidence of discriminant validity. The second method is called Maximum Shared Variance, or MSV method. MSV for each construct is the maximum value of all square correlations of that construct with other constructs. If AV for each construct is greater than MSV for that construct, then we have evidence of discriminant validity. As you can see, they are essentially the same. In my opinion, the MSV method is easier to present and interpret, and I will use the MSV method in this video. To do that, we need to extract the correlation coefficients among three factors from CFA outputs. We go back to AMOS output text and select estimates. We scroll down until we see correlation section. Right click and select copy. Then we paste the values to Excel. We will add another column called square correlation. Equal sign. Select the correlation value, which is cell 04, cap sign 2, and hit enter. This is the square correlation between F1 and F2. Then we drag this down to copy the formula. I will delete the correlations among error terms since we do not use them. Now we need to identify the MSV for each construct. To do that, we need to find the maximum square correlations of that construct with all other constructs. For example, MSV for F1 is the maximum of square correlations between F1 and F2 and between F1 and F3. We calculated those square correlations in the previous step. They are 0.307 and 0.127. Hence, MSV for F1 is 0.307. Similarly, MSV for F2 is maximum of 0.307 and 0.158, which is 0.307. Finally, MSV for F3 is maximum of 0.127 and 0.158, which is 0.158. Now we put AVE and MSV values side by side in a table for comparison. As you can see, for all three constructs, the AVE is greater than the MSV. Hence, we can conclude that we have evidence for the discriminant validity. Presenting the results in this table format makes it very easy for the reviewers and reader to follow. On the final note, I would recommend presenting all results of CFA model fit, construct reliability and validity in the same table. It would make it easier for reviewers and readers to see all results in one table rather than having to go through multiple tables to find the results. This method is particularly useful in journal publications since journals set strict requirements for the length and number of tables. It is also an effective way to present results in dissertation as many small tables are harder to read and understand than one consolidated table. This is an example how to present all reliability and validity results in one table that I used in one of my publications. As you can see, I put in the table all factors, items in each factor, and standardized factor loadings for all items. Then I put in Cronbach's alpha, construct validity, AVE, and MSV for each construct. With this one table, I can show the construct reliability with Cronbach's alpha and CR, convergent validity with factor loadings and AVE, and discriminant validity by comparing AVE with MSV. And on the bottom, I put in model fit indices for the final CFA model. So that is how to test convergent and discriminant validity using AMOS and Excel. Thank you and bye now.